Hey guys, my name is That Quiet Kid, and today I'm going to show you how we can exploit a vulnerable certificate template called ESC4. In my previous video, I showed you how to exploit ESC1, and in this video, I'm going to show you how we can exploit ESC4. So the thing that we require for this exploiting ESC4 misconfigured certificate template is valid domain credentials, like the user is not like it's not required that the user is a high privilege user. It can be a normal domain user and write permissions over that certificate template. So what we're doing here is basically overwriting the certificate template to ESC1. So first we need a valid domain credentials. I can show you that if I run the command net user and specify the user Reze, you can see that it's not a part of a privileged group. It's a normal domain user. So I'm going to use this in order to exploit ESC4. So first we need to find out if there is a vulnerable template or not. So for that we use a tool called certipy find dash vulnerable dash dc dash ip, which is my domain controller's ip, which is 192.168.0.170 in my case, and username is reze at the rate domain, which is berserk.local, and the password is bomb devil, and I'm using std out, which is a command which allows, like, it's a flag which allows me to like print the output instead of saving it to a file. Press enter. And you can see that it is trying to find vulnerable certificate templates. So as you can see that I have ESC1, a template named ESC1, and it is vulnerable to ESC1 as well. And I have a template called ESC4, and it is vulnerable to ESC4. So what we are going to do here is we can see that we have write permissions, like it's a normal domain user, and domain users have write property, or you can say write access control over this certificate template. So for this we are going to use a resource called payload all the things. So if you simply Google payload all the things AD, if you scroll down, you will find all the certificate templates, like ways how to exploit these certificate templates. Access control. This is the access control vulnerability. As I told you earlier, that we have write property over a certificate template. That's why we can exploit this ESC4 if we have a write property over a certain template. So for that, we are using certipy. So first we need to override the configuration to make it vulnerable to ESC4. Copy the first command, and we need to make a few changes to it. First of all, the change is remove the quotation marks. Like, you can keep it, but I'm removing it. It's specifying hashes. We don't have a hash. We have a valid username and password. So I'm going to use dash u reze at the rate berserk.local, which is my domain, and password. And my domain controller IP, which is 192.168.1.170. Okay, we have successfully updated ESC4, and let's run the certipy command again to see if this ESC4, which was vulnerable to only ESC4, is it vulnerable to ESC1 as well. As you can see, our template name ESC4 is now vulnerable to all ESC1, ESC2, ESC3 and ESC4. So basically we have overwritten the template and made it vulnerable to ESC1. Now I'm going to use one of my blocks that I have written in order to show you how we can exploit this ESC1. You can also follow my previous video to see how I exploited ESC1. It's pretty straightforward from here. So if you simply search for ESC1 exploit, scroll down and you can see this Oh, okay, so this is a blog that I have written on exploiting ESC1. So all now we need to do is request a certificate. So copy the command, paste it here. Now our certificate, now this template is vulnerable to ESC1, so we can exploit it. First, find out what's the DNS. It should be my domain controller. It's dc2.berserk.local. Copy it. Paste it here. And we are going to target a user instead of this administrator. We are going to target a user called Guts, which in this case, in previous video, in my previous like lab, Guts was a normal domain user, but I have created a new lab, and in this lab, Guts is a domain admin. I can show you. I have now two domain controllers in my like lab. So if you type net user Guts, you can see that now it's a member of domain admins group. So we are going to be targeting this Guts user, and template name is ESC4. The target is dc2.berserk.local. The certificate authority is, I think it's at the top, Berserk DC2 CA. Copy this, paste it here. The password was bomb devil, and the username that we had was Reze. Okay, so all the changes are made. We are requesting a certificate on behalf of like the Guts domain admin user. Okay, so we have got a certificate on behalf of this Guts user, and now we are going to use this certificate to get the domain. Now we will use this certificate to authenticate, and we will get a ticket granting ticket TGT for this Guts user, as well as NT hash, NTLM hash. The reason why we get this NTLM hash is it's like a fallback. If Kerberos authentication fails, then it falls back to NTLM. So that's why we're getting a TGT for that Guts user, as well as NTLM hash. So simply copy this command, make a few changes. So it's 170. And the certificate is, it's Guts. I think it's Guts. Yes. Okay, so we are authenticated using this Guts user certificate. So we specify Guts. Okay, so now we have got the hash for Guts user. You can see trying to get TGT, got TGT. We got the ticket granting ticket for this user, and it's a cached ticket that is saved to guts.cache, and it's also trying to get the NT hash for this user. And now we have got the NT hash as so we can verify this that the credentials are valid using crackmap exec 192.168.170. We can authenticate against the domain controller guts and hash. Okay. So as you can see, we have successfully exploited ESC4. So the reason why it was vulnerable was, I can show you. So if we go to here, it's ESC4, its properties, and its security. Yes. Now it's like ESC4, we have overwritten it, but The only thing different in ESC 4 was that we had write permissions over a, like, we didn't require anything. I can show you. If we simply delete this ESC 4 now, I can simply duplicate this template, name it ESC 4 part 2, and make some few ch make some few changes to it. So authenticated users can have read write access and domain users have read write access. Okay. And apart from this, we have, let me make a few changes. Subject name is, we don't even require enrollee supply subject. We basically override it. So we don't need this and we make the changes. You see, and let's issue this certificate as well. ESC part 4. Now let me restart. Let me restart this. Now, if we rerun the command, you can see that this ESC4 part 2 is now vulnerable to ESC4. So, the only thing with this like misconfiguration in this template is that we have write permissions over a template. So, we can basically modify it to any of the templates. And in this case, we modified it to ESC1 and exploited it to gain domain admin access inside the network. So if I change, all I need to do is make a few changes. Let's go to tools, it's certificate authority, certificate templates, ESC4, and let's see its properties. I think it's from here. It's ESC part 4. Okay. So if we go to properties and security, and if we remove that write access, now you will see it is no longer vulnerable. Okay. ESC4, we have deleted this. Let me remove it. Okay, so now let's rerun the command and see if it's still vulnerable to ESC4 or not. As you can see, we no longer have a ESC4 vulnerable template. We only have ESC1, which was which I showed you in the previous video as well. Like, I showed you how to exploit ESC1, and you can see that now we don't have the ESC4 vulnerable template. So if you have a write permissions over a template, you can basically modify it or overwrite it to ESC1 and gain domain admin access inside the network. So that's it for this video, and thank you for watching.